The Ohio Supreme Court is considering a challenge to Ohio's five-year-old smoking ban. We thought we were done with this. The owner of Zeno's Bar, Victorian Village, says the law violates his property rights. The bar owner argues he should decide whether he should engage in risky behavior, not the law. He said the suit says it's unfair also to punish a bar because its customers choose to ignore the no smoking signs that he has posted. The state of Ohio said the intent of the law is simple: protect the health of workers and customers. Laura Bischoff, should bar owners, their argument, bar owners should not be penalized if their customers choose to light up?
Well, at the same time, though, they're under, I don't know if it's a legal obligation or what, but, you know, if their customers are getting too bummed and they're supposed to cut them off, mm-hmm. So why is this any different? You just go to the, you know, no smoking, it's not allowed, please stop smoking. It's pretty easy. And I, you know, I think that, the 1851 Center for Constitutional Law, Maurice Thompson is the lawyer for that, and he's arguing that that enforcement is, like you said, unconstitutional because it cites the business, not the smoker, and that he also argues that it amounts to unconstitutional taking of private property by restricting pre-existing business activity. Now, if he were to win, then you could overturn all kinds of regulations. You could say that you know, businesses used to be allowed to freely dispose of hazardous materials, they were allowed to manufacture unsafe products, they were allowed to pay lower minimum wage. All of those regulations certainly impact their bottom line, so could those be unconstitutional as well?
Can a bar say, look, we only cater to adults who smoke, even, mm-hmm. say, okay, so we're not Bob Evans, we're not Applebee's, we're not Max and Irma's, where we have families and a different clientele. Is there any legal standing for that? Do they have the right to say we should be allowed to smoke here?
I think that the right to swing your fist stops where your neighbor's nose begins. And this kind of goes back to our earlier conversation about exotic animals. You know, you have them until they get loose, and then it becomes a problem for everybody in the neighborhood. So you have to have some rules, some regulations on this. I think we do have to do this. I will also tell you, though, that if you really want to find a bar that will allow you to smoke in there, look for the Altoid tins lined up on the bar, because that's where everybody drops their ashes. They drop their little cigarette stubs in there as soon as somebody they don't know walks in. They're doing it right now, and this goes to the issue of, you got to be careful you don't drive some activity underground, too.
Well, and of course, you know, the underlying complaint that the bars in particular had with the ban itself is that it unfairly attacked them because of their clientele who
right.
smoke.
So. Right.
I mean, we haven't seen a big economic impact. I mean, it's hard to gauge exactly the impact because bars go out of business all the time. But
here's the real interesting thing. If issue 3 actually were to pass, mm-hmm. Because it mandates, you know, how health insurance is enacted or compelled after, you know, March of 2010, any legislation after that could be challenged. And quite frankly, it might be a stronger challenge then if issue 3 passes than it is now.